Have you been reading the Daily Office? I hope you have. And if you have, yesterday morning you would have heard a very powerful portion of Isaiah. And it started out like this: "Oh Lord, you have done wonderful things. You have been a strength to the poor, the needy, a refuge from the storm, a shadow from the heat." And then he went on to say, "The Lord will swallow up death in victory and wipe away tears from off all faces." So prophesied Isaiah. That's the Easter message, isn't it? Jesus died for our sins. He rose for our justification. He restored to us everlasting life. And he enabled us to put away all the legions and leavens of malice and wickedness and serve him in pureness of living and truth. That comes from today's collect. Now that's a lot of stuff to do, I think, as we, as pilgrims and followers of our Lord Jesus. So the question may become, can we do that thing, all of those things, quickly? Well, sadly, or realistically, really, few things of substance are accomplished quickly. And things eternal take a lifetime, and that's what we're talking about, is things eternal. The first step, however, is something that we can start, and that is we can immerse ourselves in that which Jesus gave his disciples today. Peace. The doors being shut, we hear. The disciples gathered for fear of the Jews, and Jesus entered and he said, "Peace be with you." And we can immerse ourselves in that which Jesus gave the disciples that day. And then we will be able to, as the epistle for today is also from John, the epistle and the gospel, as the epistle puts it, we can then subsequently overcome the world. Now it happened to the disciples, most assuredly, when the fear was replaced by God's peace, by the peace of Christ Jesus. And it happens to us also as followers of our Lord. Becoming God's faithful servant is a never-ending experience, to say the least. Now, how can that happen? Well, here's a couple of temporal examples which may help. Let's say that you really like to play golf and you want to be a good golfer. What do you have to do in order to become a member, for example, of the PGA? Wouldn't that be fabulous? Well, I'll tell you what you have to do. You have to play golf consistently every single day. If you don't, you won't make it. You just won't. You may have a wicked miniature golf score, but that's not real golf, is it? Now, another example, and this is one that we can kind of relate to. Musicians. You know, musicians are kind of peculiar, aren't they? Well, some of them are and some of them aren't. But if you are a musician, always make your music in life a priority. Don't let daily life ever keep you from working on your passion. Someone gave that to me this morning, early in this morning, from a person that I both admire and adore. And it's true. You have to really commit to doing things, whether it is a golfer or a musician. Now, it's the same with most temporal endeavors. You can't do something haphazardly and expect to excel in whatever you're attempting to do. Systematic, constant, never-ending commitment, day in and day out, that's what it's called, and that's what we need. Likewise, if you want to overcome the world, it will take commitment the likes of which you may not have experienced, because by that attempt, you will be at odds with the world and its standards. We know that, as Jesus told us himself. He said, in the world you shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. And he has. And we must, as followers and pilgrims, in his footsteps. And then today, and I put this in the bulletin so you can remember it, we hear St. Francis de Sales give us a question. Does anyone fail to see that the world is an unjust judge, gracious and well disposed to its own children, but harsh and rigorous towards the children of God? I think we understand that, don't we? We get a lot of bad looks and dirty looks and other things from the godless people in our life. So what keeps us from doing the right regarding the faith? Have you figured it out? Well, I'll tell you, many things really, but there is something that works in a very subtle way in our world. And it's one of the seven deadly sins. And it dogs us as followers of Christ. What is it, the dominant sin of our day? It is sloth. Spiritual indifference. Disinclination to act on one's faith. Words and deeds too. Sloth is so deadly a choice because it sets us up in the end to lose our faith altogether. You know, we're not Christians simply because we wear a cross round our neck. You know, that's not it. And look like one. We become his when we put away the leaven of malice and wickedness and serve him in pureness of living and in truth and follow him all the days of our life. If we are a Christian, we always make our faith the priority in life. And we can never let daily life ever keep us from working on our faith all the way into eternity. And that's our goal, isn't it? The beatific vision. As John Bunyan poetically put it in that song that we sang, he who would valiant be against all disaster, let him in constancy follow the master. There's no discouragement shall make him once relent his first avowed intent to be a pilgrim. Since, Lord, thou dost defend us with thy spirit, we know we at the end shall life inherit. Then, fancy flees away, I'll fear not what men say. I will labor night and day to be his pilgrim.